Hey everybody, welcome back to Kelly's Homemade Kitchen. Today we are going to make some banana nut bread from scratch, of course. And I had originally planned to make a loaf, but I think instead we're gonna do muffins. It's of course the exact same recipe. You can pour it into a butt cake pan if you want. But as I said, I've got a muffin pan, so let's make some banana nut muffins. All right, now, first thing, you want your bananas to be very ripe. Not rotten, but, you know, maybe just a couple days away from that. And most recipes call for 1 cup of mashed bananas. I like putting 2 cups in. Obviously not necessary, but it's banana nut bread, so I want to taste the banana. So, at any rate, just get those mashed up. 1 to 2 cups, whatever your preference is. Gonna end up making it look almost like something would be in a baby food jar. All right, put that into your mixing bowl. Okay, now, I use buttermilk, and a lot of your banana nut bread recipes call for buttermilk, but usually that's just not something that's in your refrigerator at any given time. But what you can do is take 1 teaspoon of either lemon juice or white vinegar and put it into 1/3 of a cup of whole milk. Let it sit for like 10 minutes. And you got buttermilk. So in your large bowl, we've mashed the bananas. We are going to add the buttermilk. Three eggs, farm eggs, of course. And most recipes call for 2. I put an extra one in because the egg's whole purpose for being in recipes is to hold it together, whether it's a cake, bread, muffins, even a meatloaf. That's your whole purpose of eggs, so it doesn't get all crumbly and fall apart on you. And everyone knows that a muffin can be crumbly, and this is a convenience type breakfast food, then you want something you can eat and drive without making a mess all over yourself. So I use an extra egg. Okay, we are also going to add 1/2 cup of melted butter, which, if you recall, 1 stick of butter is equal to 1/2 cup. 1 pinch of cinnamon, and a pinch is the same thing as 1/8 of a teaspoon. We are also going to put in 1 pinch of salt. Two teaspoons of vanilla. It takes 3 teaspoons to make a tablespoon, but we are going to use 2. All right, and whisk until well combined. You know, some of these banana nut bread recipes will tell you to completely mash the bananas into this practical goo so that there's no lumps. Well, maybe it's just me, but I like tasting those lumps of banana in the banana nut bread. Like I said, I add an extra cup of that. So you'll learn as you go along that you can tweak and alter things and not necessarily ruin it. It might actually make it better. Okay. One cup of packed light brown sugar. Packed meaning, you know, there's a lot of air in brown sugar. So if you just poured out of the bag into your measuring container, it's not gonna equal out. So you want it so packed that you practically, like I am, have to dig it out. of the measuring cup. So that's one cup. We're gonna add our half a cup of walnuts. Whisk until well combined. Okay, we are almost done here, right? Almost ready to put these in the muffin pans. Okay. We're going to add our 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Baking soda, not baking powder. Our 1 3/4 cup of all-purpose King Arthur flour. And once again, whisk until well combined. It's starting to get thick, which is what flour does. You know, we could have never put that real runny batter as it was before putting the flour in. We could have never put that in the oven and baked it. It would have just turned into a big glob of soup. All right. This is what you want it to look like. Thick. Well blended. Okay. Now I am choosing to use the paper cupcake holders. If you choose not to, it doesn't matter either way, just spray your muffin pan before putting in your batter. This is supposed to be a non-stick pan to start with, but you know, that can go either way. So, here we go. Let's use an ice cream scoop. Put a little baking spray on the inside of that. And you want to fill your muffin compartment up to about 3/4 full. If you fill it completely, it'll overflow on you. So about 3/4 full, or one regular ice cream scoop. Okay, that didn't turn out too well. Let's just start over on that one. Okay. Oh boy, always gotta have a technical. Okay, let's try this again. Your spatula might not be a bad idea here. Sorry about that. I'm trying to situate myself so you can see what I'm doing. As I have mentioned before, I desperately need a full-time cameraman if I'm gonna be successful at this. Let's see if I can rearrange here. Maybe. Okay, let's try. Sorry, I really am. I appreciate your patience. I appreciate you subscribing to my channel. And for anyone who isn't aware, I have been working from home for almost a year now, baking my heart out, not for free. But I don't charge ridiculously high prices. As a matter of fact, Thanksgiving was the first holiday that I baked for, and I only charged like $8 for pumpkin pie or even an 8-inch cheesecake. It was not made in the big springform pan like you saw in the video a few days ago, but I started out selling, you know, with really low prices to get a good customer base going. And it's worked, and those that have continued to order regularly off of me, my prices have went up a little, but nothing ridiculous. But my regular customers, you know, I always charge them a little less than everyone else. So I'm doing birthday cakes, anniversary cakes, pies, you name it. If it can be baked, most likely I can make it. Okay, we have got our muffin pan filled with our batter. I'm going to put that into a 325 degree oven, which I have already preheated, of course. When these are done, as well as the rest of the batter, I'll be right back to show you the outcome. Thanks for watching.